What's up, everybody? Today, we're going to be taking a look at how to create structured data via ChatGPT, and then how to implement that structured data within Squarespace and WordPress. The first type of schema that we're going to be looking at is for FAQs, and the second is going to be for software application. However, you can replicate this for any of the hundreds of properties and types that are readily available on schema.org. So the first thing that I'm going to do is copy and paste the prompt persona that I created for digital marketing. And you can access this by clicking on the link in the description below. I'm just going to simply copy this and hop over to ChatGPT. I have 4 enabled, and I've also enabled the WebPilot plugin because I wanted to access one of my pages later on in this video. It's going to greet me, and I'm going to follow it up with a prompt that I've already previously wrote for FAQs. And what this is asking it to do is simply to generate it, but generate it in a very specific way. I want it to always start and end with a script, because if you don't do that, depending on your CMS, it can kind of throw things through a loop. It might actually appear on the front end, and we don't want that to occur. And then we also want it to create a link at the end of its structured data so that we can validate its work. So the questions that we're going to be taking a look at are for a client called Eden Green. They're a wonderful hydroponic vertical farming company. And these are the questions at hand. So we're just going to copy those and drop them directly beneath our prompt. And now we wait. All right, and we're back. So it finished, and let's validate the schema. So we'll click on the link and we will copy the code. We will go to code snippet and then paste the code. And this is great. This is exactly what we want to see. There are 0 errors and there are 0 warnings for all of our questions and all of our answers. So now let's hop over to our Squarespace site. And we're just going to go down to the bottom and we're going to create a new block, and we're going to select code. HTML is fine. We're going to remove what is there. And we're just going to click out of it. Now, guys, you're going to see embedded scripts. Don't worry, this isn't actually going to appear on the front end of your site. You're just going to click save. I have the page already available to us, so I'm going to reload it. I'm going to come over and I'm going to do a new test and then run that test. And what that should do is show us that, yep, it's here. So these are other types of structured data that are already built into the Squarespace site that we're looking at today. And then here's the FAQ page that we just added. And you can see that there are 0 errors and there are 0 warnings. So that went well. Now let's take a look at how to implement structured data within WordPress. And again, I'm going to take a look at how to build software application structured data for a tool that I created on my site. Again, it's totally free if you want to check it out. It's a keyword density checker. You just add your primary keywords in here, you paste your article, and it will populate how many times you've used that keyword, if you've used it too many times, but I'm not going to bore you with all of that. So we're going to ask ChatGPT to lend us a hand with that. All right, guys, so what I did here was I asked it to use the WebPilot plugin to access the page that we just took a look at. And it's going to create the software application structured data. And if you don't already know what type of structured data should go on a page, you can simply just ask ChatGPT. Now, it's not going to know every type and property that's available within the documentation. You're going to have to kind of go through and parse that data yourself. But it is going to give you a very strong launching pad for you to start building your structured data off of. And similar to what we did with the previous one, I'm going to ask it to start and end with script and also provide me with a link to validate its work. All right, so ChatGPT finished, and let's validate its work. So we're just going to copy its code, and let's validate the schema. Now, for something like this, where you're asking WebPilot to actually crawl the page, you just kind of want to comb through and make sure that it's pulling all of the necessary information. Whereas previously, we were actually giving it the necessary information, we knew that it was going to be accurate. For this, it's kind of using its best judgment to pull and figure out what is the most important bits. So I'm just going to do that real quick. Yeah, that description is very accurate. The feature list, it analyzes keyword density of a page. Yeah, it uses a density threshold. Yeah, this is pretty good. The one thing that I'm actually going to delete from here is a screenshot, because I don't have a screenshot on this page. It's probably something I should add, but just for the purposes of this video, I will remove that before we implement it. But everything else looks perfect. So I'm just going to make sure I have that copied, and we're going to edit the page. Now, I've already done this for this page, so we're just going to come down to the header script. And your WordPress may look different than mine, depending on what plugins you have set up, what theme you have installed. But I'm coming down to where it says scripts here, header scripts, and I'm just going to find an available section. Now, again, I've already done this in the past, so I'm going to delete this section, plug in the new section, and again, I'm going to remove the screenshot because I don't actually have that available, and I'm going to update the page. We're going to view the page, and then we're going to validate our new work. So come over to fetch URL, run test, and if everything goes well, we should see our new, yeah, we see it. So software application is now available. And the page also has a couple of other different structured datas available. So guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video on how to create structured data with ChatGPT, how to implement it within Squarespace, how to implement it within WordPress, and also how to validate your work. Now, I've also created a video on how to audit structured data of a website, which is really great because you can take a look at what's currently available on your site, or you can see what a competitor is doing. And that's a great way to identify if this competitor is a direct competitor of yours and they're using a whole bunch of structured data, you might want to start considering to use that as well on your own site. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't like this video, give it a thumbs up anyway, and I'll see you next time.